Do I enjoy watching a red-headed princess turn into a queen? Yeah, I do. And the fact of the matter is that plenty of people will see themselves reflected in this most recent historical fiction series, The Spanish Princess Brought to Life on Starz. The story itself is based on Philippa Gregory's books, The Constant Princess and The King's Curse. It's a continuation of the series of books by the same names, The White Queen and The White Princess. So while this is a limited series, it also continues a storyline. A storyline which Starz has available for you to watch, so it's not necessary to watch those shows before you catch up on this one, but it won't hurt. And in fact, it'll make it all make more sense, especially the parts about Elizabeth of York. The story of the Tudors is one that has fascinated people for years, and there have been plenty of movies and TV shows based around this royal family. Usually the story of Henry VIII starts with an older Catherine of Aragon being shunned for a much younger, hotter Anne Boleyn. This version, adapted by Emma Frost and Matthew Graham, shows the beginning of Catherine of Aragon's story. What many do not realize is that one, just because she was Spanish, does not mean she had black hair. It was in fact red, just like this version. And two, she was married to Henry VIII for 24 years before he annulled their marriage. The Spanish princess gives us her triumphant part of the story. Catherine is the daughter of Ferdinand and Isabella. Yes, the same ones who funded Christopher Columbus's journey. And these people had tons of money and England wanted it. Hence the reason they sent their daughter off to marry a prince she had never met. When she goes to court, she takes her own ladies, one of whom is an African Moor, and the other Spanish. She also has African guards. What makes this edition great is that these characters are historically accurate. Yes, black people were around in England during this time period, and yes, Catherine of Aragon had an ethnically diverse staff. For years, these stories have been told in the same, albeit wrong, way. But recently, there's been a pushback against the traditional tales for the historically accurate ones, which naturally includes people of all races. We see Catherine of Aragon telling people what she wants when she wants it. She is no simpering miss who's been sent to wed a man she has never met before. And a sidetrack to the costuming of this series, it blew me away. I will not be surprised at all to see some corseted wedding gowns coming to a bridal runway near you. Also, Her Grace, the King's mother, wears a hat that looks like the roof of a house, and it's awesome! While most of us cannot relate to living in palaces and arranged marriages, this show doesn't shy away from subject matter we can all relate to. Grief is shown in a way that is very real. And being in control of your own self, even when you cannot control the circumstances around you, is a main theme. I don't know that anybody would choose to marry two brothers, although this show definitely makes Prince Harry the hot one. They make her first husband, Prince Arthur, feel very weak, which might help in the implication that she never slept with him. Which all comes into play later on when, you know, she gets put away. This show immerses you in the world of the Tudors in a way I had never seen it done before, and I truly enjoyed it. It's definitely a must-watch if you like historical fiction. And redheaded queens.